I was involved in the early 90s production of Roots. It was done by Scottish people. The reviewer said white people could never truly do Roots, but we captured the feeling of grabbing a bull by the balls. However, there was an incident. Recent events have made me think of this. There was a Turkish man who insisted on playing Kunta Kinte. We had told him many times that Ian was going to play Kunta Kinte. But this Turkish man would not take no for an answer. He had read the wrong kind of acting book. So, on the night of the play, he came dressed in full regalia for the part and sat in the audience. He acted out the role. Finally, after the first act, we had to ask to have him removed. It was a shaming thing for us and them. Mostly for us. Many people who were sitting near him said he did a better job than Ian. And that I was impartial because I fancied Ian. As true as that may be, I really think that we could have had a chance if it were not for the Turkish Kunta Kinte. His disruptions, even after he was ejected, a few fans followed him outside because he put on his performance in the street. And then slowly but surely those fans, equipped with their damnable cell phones, called their friends. In half an hour there were more people outside watching Turkish Kunta Kinte than there were inside watching our play. We had practiced for months. Scottish production of Roots was to be one of the most memorable events of the season. It was, but not in the way that we intended. So whenever I hear about world events taking a downward turn, I think of the damn Turks. It's the only explanation. They seem to revel in such things, and I base this on my vast experience with one Turk in particular. His name, who I've heard perhaps once or twice, has been blotted out by my brain. Destroying our little community production, especially since we had to pay £250 just to put it on. It was the most grievous blow to the arts the region has seen in years. Years, I say. So no, I will not be an apologist for performances that fail. I accept that our performance failed. That our performance failed, I accept it. How's that? That's what you all want me to do. You want me to accept failure. You choke it down my gullet like some gruel served at a prison. Well, I shall. And I'll smile. I'll put a little salt on it and say it's yummy. Bastards. It's always the bastards. The Turkish bastards. Bob was his name. The bastard. It was Bob, the bastardly Bob. Is it so true? It all makes sense now. He followed me to Canberra. Damnable Turkish sense of pride. He was going to harass me to the ends of the earth. Bastardly Bob. And all I wanted was to find my way out of Canberra. I'd never been to Canberra before. And he said, we'll have some wallaby. I said, fuck the wallaby. Eat the wallaby, fuck the wallaby. Eat the wallaby, fuck the wallaby. What else is there to do? They put me away. They did, rightfully so. I'd have put myself away had I managed such a thing. But when I get out, if I get out, am I out? Yes, I think I'm out. When I get out, I told myself things would be different. I would make an extended effort in order to embrace normalcy. Normality, it would be my companion, like a wart. And once I had done that, then I could go back home and put on another production of Roots or Seven Brides for Seven Brothers. Something involving Scottish people and overacting. But no, here I am, wherever the hell I am. I'll get out one day. You realize that, don't you? I'll get out one day. And then we'll see who's the Turk and who's Kunta Kinte.